This video covers insulin resistance testing options, including how to calculate your HOMA-IR score for insulin resistance. Despite what you may have heard, insulin resistance can be reversed. The sooner you take action on what you learned today, the faster you can take action and lower your risk for diabetes, heart disease, obesity, and dementia. There are a few ways to test for insulin resistance. The three that are covered in this video are fasting insulin, the HOMA-IR, and triglyceride to HDL ratio. First, you can request an insulin blood test from your physician. Often the test will be covered by your insurance, but not always. Not all physicians are on the insulin resistance wagon yet, so they may be reluctant or plain unhelpful. The good news is if you're willing to pay out of pocket, you can get an insulin test without a physician's order. We offer an at-home option that requires just a finger prick from home, and then you send it back in the mail. Just go to zivli.com/testing to order today. You can also use a company like walkinlab.com and labtestsonline.org to purchase an insulin test. If you order through one of those other companies just mentioned, you'll still have to go to the lab for a blood draw. An optimal fasting insulin level is less than 6 microunits per milliliter. If you can, try to get a fasting glucose level at the same time as your fasting insulin. If you have a glucometer, you can bring it to the lab with you or check your glucose at home while you're doing your insulin test. Then save that number so you can calculate your homeostatic model assessment for insulin resistance or HOMA-IR score when you get your insulin level back. This is more helpful than fasting insulin or glucose tests alone in determining your insulin sensitivity. Often you'll see HOMA-IR as the outcome measure in studies that measure insulin resistance outcomes. Here is the equation to determine your HOMA score. In the US, it's glucose times insulin divided by 405. For most other countries, it's glucose times insulin divided by 22.5. There is no consensus on a normal value yet, but a value of 1.5 likely determines that you have insulin resistance. The last estimate for insulin resistance that is quick and easy to calculate is your triglyceride to HDL ratio. This is an indicator of the health of your LDL. Research indicates this may be the best surrogate marker of insulin resistance and metabolic syndrome. To calculate this, you simply take your triglyceride number divided by your HDL number. While it's considered healthy to have a ratio of 2:1, closer to 1:1 for this ratio is optimal. Triglycerides and HDL are on your standard blood draw you'd get from your physician. If you don't have a physician or have been avoiding getting your blood work done because you're afraid they'll suggest a medication, we have a cardiometabolic panel on our website that includes insulin, triglycerides, HDL, and other biomarkers. Again, that URL is zivli.com/testing. We hope you found this episode helpful and that you actually take action and check your insulin. It can be really motivating to see how your insulin, triglycerides, HDL, and other biomarkers are changing as you improve your lifestyle, so you're not just relying on the scale for feedback. Be sure to subscribe to this channel for more helpful tips on losing weight and lowering insulin resistance, and check out the other episodes in this playlist.